all passes.
On a side note, because we got this specific question this week, what is the, in your opinion, what would you say is the correlation between overhead press and bench? Because the question asked, okay, if I want to increase my bench, should I be doing overhead press?
So I don't think it's a bad exercise, but I don't think...
Does it take away? Do you think if someone wanted to become a power lifter and improve their bench, should they be doing overhead press?
I wouldn't make it a centerpiece of my program personally. I don't think it's a bad exercise. I think that you could make the case that an overhead press, but probably more so a push press, has more athletic carryover than a bench press, because you're using the legs to drive an upper body movement, which is, it's very rare in actual sports that you're just going to strictly press. You know, you're usually going to be driving your legs into it. It's going to be more of a dynamic movement. Most of the power, like the top power lifters I know, and their programming and coaches and stuff, strictly from a powerlifting perspective, I would say most of them don't place a priority on overhead press, but some incorporate it. And part of that is learning.
Or they do incline.
Incline for sure. Incline for sure. But just a straight up overhead press.
Straight military press,
You know, if your shoulders are the weak point, if you determine like weak shoulders is, or, you know, like front delts, you know, is, you know, a weak point in your bench, then maybe you would need to use more of that. For most people, it's probably not. You know, it's definitely probably more triceps before front delts, in my experience.
Gotcha.
You never get the triceps strong enough for a big bench. And doing so...
Stabilizers, baby.
Doing so is going to put a lot less mileage on your joints if done smartly than training really heavy overhead pressing. Really heavy overhead pressing for most people just beats the shoulders up. Yeah. You know, with a barbell especially.
Oh, yeah.
Dumbbell is another story. A slight incline is better, but straight up military pressing or behind the neck military pressing, it can be pretty good.
I don't even do behind the neck military press anymore, man. I used to love that, but I just... it was my neck, too. Like your neck, your shoulders, everything's just,